Mr. Eddie Griffin.
I want to fuck Michelle Obama. I need her on my team. I'm waiting on Obama to fuck up. That nigga slip up, I'ma slide right in. What's happening, Michelle? You like comedy? That's a fine chocolate motherfucker. You understand me? I didn't vote for Obama because of him. I voted because of her. This is the first lady that is fuckable. Because you didn't want to fuck Daddy Bush's wife. She looked like she jumped off the dollar bill. That's George Washington. And you didn't want to fuck George Jr.'s wife. She looked like the mama on Damien Omen. Every time I see her face, all I hear is, ha-hee-hee-hee-ha. Look like the bitch head about to spin around any moment. And I don't think you wanted to fuck Hillary either. I don't think Hillary liked it. She wear more pantsuits than a brother at a funeral. Now, here's how I know Obama got some pimp in him. All right? Remember when Hillary was running against him? She talking all that shit about Obama. Obama got the job. He gave her a job. That's pimping. And what job did the brother give her? Secretary of State. What's the Secretary of State's job? Get the fuck out the country. He banished that bitch to foreign lands. And the happiest motherfucker about it is Bill Clinton. You know Bill at home, thank you, Obama. I get my dick sucked every day. Now, I knew Obama. I knew he had some nigga in him. You know, because at first you couldn't tell, but one day it jumped out of him. Y'all remember that day him and George Bush was walking outside the White House and his swag was on 250? I'm sitting at the crib watching it on TV. I said, that motherfucker's a pimp. You could damn near hear the conversation. Hurry up and get your shit out of my house. Take your punk ass back to Texas. You bitch. Because at first, I thought Obama was an African-American. And white people, I know y'all think all black people the same. We just like you white folks. You got different kind of white folks. You got honkies, you got crackers, you got rednecks, you got white guys. Black people the same way. You got black folks, just don't want to be bothered. You got old Negroes, I sure wish slavery come back. Massa was so good to us. And you got African Americans, I graduated from college, Kundalai. And then you have niggas, which I happen to be a member of. Because niggas know it's some bullshit right around the corner. You know how they say there's no more racism? You know, since Obama got in office, you know, you got a black president, there's no more racism. Bullshit. They just got slick with the shit. They don't say nigger anymore. They just say, we're not hiring. Translation, nigger. I'm sorry, your bank loan has been denied. Nigger. Pull over, nigger. And Obama, here's how I really knew he had some nigger in him. He threw a barbecue at the White House. He invited the NBA, the NFL, every rapper. I think I was the only nigger that wasn't there. You know, white people were sitting at home. My God, it's all over. The niggers are barbecuing. They're licking their fingers. They're licking their fingers. They got collard greens and black eyed peas. Here's how I really knew he was from the hood. He put a swing set. I don't think y'all heard me. He put a swing set on the White House lawn. That's some nigga shit. He got enough money and power to send his daughters to Disneyland every day, every day. He said, fuck that, put that swing set outside that window so I keep my eye on they little ass. Because black people, we watch our kids. I'm talking to you, white folks. I'm tired of seeing y'all kids on my milk carton. You know, you just trying to pull some milk on your cereal, and there's always that little white face with the caption underneath it. Have you seen me? No, I ain't seen your little ass, and how come your parents don't know where the hell you at? You ain't never seen little brothers and sisters on a milk carton. Because if you did, they'd be posing. When white people tell their kids to go out and play, they mean that shit. They kids be 5 miles away, nigga, they out in the woods. Next thing you know, they duct tape in the back of the van. Living in somebody's tent in the backyard for 20 motherfucking years. Y'all remember the little white bitch that was in the backyard? I'm sorry, I didn't mean to call her a little white bitch. I don't know the whole, the little white bitch was in the backyard. That ain't motherfucking kidnapping, that's adoption. 20 years, you gotta feed and clothe this little motherfucker? Black people, we trying to get rid of our own kids. Here, take one of these motherfuckers. I remember when we was coming up, black people, back me up on this. When we coming up, remember your parents tell you you could play to the end of this block. Remember, that's as far as your ass go. Ain't no going out to the woods. The end of that motherfucking block. And I remember my mama told me, if you go any further, I'ma fuck you up. I remember one day, me and my partner, Dawg and Junie, we kicking it, right? We get up to the corner, nigga. Boom, boom. They like, Ed, come on, let's go on the next block. Let's see what's over there. Boy, I was nervous. That's when you look down to see if your mama on the front porch. My mama looked at me dead in the eye. I couldn't hear her, but her mouth said, my Uncle Bucky had his pistol. He's like, I can shoot your ass from here. Nigga, I'm like, They're like, you ain't going in? I'm like, nah, man, you know, I caught a Charlie horse. You know, because I ain't trying to look like no punk, man. I got a horse, you know. They're like, oh, you old bitch-ass nigga. I said, I'll be the bitch today. I'd rather fight both of y'all than take one ass whooping from her. See ya. Mama beat me out of the penitentiary. As y'all can see, eyes free. And obviously, y'all parents whooped y'all out the penitentiary because y'all here, Reese free. Them two brothers I'm talking about locked up right now. Because pain give you a memory of what not to do. You understand? Your partner be like, come on, Ed, let's rob this liquor store. I ain't going. I'm cool right here. Ew, it's rough being a kid nowadays, man. You know what I mean? The teachers is fucking them. The preachers is fucking them. No wonder the kids carrying guns to school. They tired of getting fucked. Everywhere they turn, somebody got a dick for them. You understand me? And y'all just got this brother, Eddie Long. Oh, don't ooh me. I didn't make the shit up. Y'all seen it, y'all. And you know, at first I had to give a brother the benefit of the doubt. You know what I mean? I'm like, nah, black preachers don't fuck little boys. That's the difference between a white church and a black church. White churches, fuck your son. Black church, fuck your wife. If you go into church and your wife is constantly sitting on the front row, nigga. Reverend dick them down. So I'm like, nah, Eddie Long, they just talking shit about this brother because he making money with his church. Then I seen one of the kids, man, he got on the news last week. And the kid was like, you know, he can't look me in my eye. And he looking dead in the camera. He can't look me in my eye. He ain't no preacher. He's a predator. I couldn't take enough showers to get his scent off of me. Nigga, I'm sitting at home. I'm like, nigga, sound like you was in love. Shit, God gave that motherfucking preacher the right last name, Long. He been long stroking them little boys. And here's how I know the motherfucker guilty. Cause he got up in the pulpit and talked for a half hour. Not one time did he say, I didn't do it. That motherfucker said, I got 5 rocks and I ain't thrown one yet. I said, that's the gayest shit I ever heard in my life. That nigga didn't say, I got 5 bullets, I ain't bust the cap on the motherfucker. That nigga said, I got 5 rocks, and I ain't thrown one yet. And did you see how the nigga dropped the mic? I sat at home, I said, he did it, he did it. He pulled out his pole of Moses, parted that little boy Red Sea, and let his people go. Just to keep it biblical. Truth like rain don't give a fuck who it fall on. I don't go to church. God don't live in church. They say the body is the temple. I'm walking in church right now. Soon as you go to church, there's somebody trying to stick a dick in you and they need some money. War in humanity's history has been over some kind of motherfucking religion. You know what I mean? I don't get caught up in that bullshit because I don't think God ever wrote a Bible or a Quran. He didn't have to write no shit. He ain't no playwright. It's written in your essence. Because the Bible is written by men. The book of Peter, the book of John, the whole book about Jesus, but that nigga ain't wrote one book. The motherfucker that is about didn't write shit. All the hangouts wrote a book. Shit, I know the nigga. And you notice in each one of them book, they the closest one to Jesus. Peter, like, shit, me and Jesus was tight, nigga. In John's book, shit, I was damn near the nigga daddy, you know. God didn't write no book. It's written in your essence. Nobody ever had to tell you it's wrong to kill your mama. Somehow you born innately knowing that. Which means you born knowing right and wrong. So put the book down, because it will fuck you up. You understand me? It starts out messed up in the beginning in the book of Genesis. In the beginning, there was Adam and Eve. And Adam and Eve had 2 sons, Cain and Abel. And Cain and Abel got married. To who? Where did did these mystery bitches come from? I like messing with Christians, man. Because they're easy to get. You can get on their skin quick, you know. You know, I tell a Christian in a minute, I say, I don't believe Jesus died on no cross. Sacrilege. I say, well, wait a minute. He could walk on water, feed 1,000 with a loaf of bread, raise the dead, but you telling me this nigga couldn't handle 3 nails? I know brothers with 9 bullet wounds still walking around. His name is 50 Cent. You telling me 50 Cent colder than Jesus? Maybe you delusional motherfucker. I bet you Jesus was a cool kid. His mama be like, now Jesus, go on in there and take a bath and don't be walking on your water. And then, that's probably why they invented the shower, just to get the nigga wet. Look at some of the Christian heads in here. You going to hell. Don't be talking about Jesus, Eddie. Don't be talking about it. You know how Jesus whistle? You know, with the hole in the hand. Look, y'all really like, nigga, that's it. The lightning's coming. Christians always the first one want to send somebody to hell. You going to hell. How the fuck you though? Like God came down, let that nigga know he going to hell. I'm kind of busy right now. You know what I mean? I made my Heavenly Father's image. If I got a sense of humor, that means God got one. God probably up there cracking up right now. Hey, Jesus, come here. That crazy nigga I made his own. He talking about your boy. He said you walk on your bath water. He said you whistle like this. I don't get mad, nigga. That shit was funny. That shit was funny. They always try to make God this uptight asshole motherfucker. You know what I mean? Like, if you get some pussy, you going to hell. You made the pussy. Shouldn't have made it so motherfucking good. I mean, what kind of catch 22 is that? Here, Eddie, here's some pussy, but don't partake in it. Shit, nigga. See, I'd be a Muslim, but the Muslim faith, they too strict. You know what I mean? You can't smoke no weed. You can't get your dick sucked by a bitch that ain't your wife. Matter of fact, you can't see your wife's face until you marry her. They keep them veiled up. All you get to see is the eyes. You really gotta love that bitch's eyes. You be like, damn, she got some pretty eyes. Then you marry her as the veil come off. Nah, 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 nah. No wonder they get 20 wives. You playing the law of averages. I'm telling you, I think Christians are jealous of Muslims. Because you ain't going to out-devout a Muslim. That's the most devout faith you ever run into. A Muslim will strap a bomb on themselves and blow themselves up about some Muhammad. Ask a Christian to put a bomb on and blow themselves up about Jesus. No, he wouldn't want me to do that. He just blessed me with this house. I'm sure he wants me to live in it. Everybody fighting over this religious shit. You understand me? The Christians say Jesus is the messenger. The Muslims say it's Muhammad. I say, who gives a fuck who the messenger is? Did you get the message? They got the same damn message. Do unto others as you would have them do unto you. Science proves that to be a fact. For every action, there's an opposite and equal reaction. Don't fuck with me, and I won't fuck with you. I'll tell you somebody who needs Jesus right around now. Tiger Woods. Do you remember when Tiger Woods kept talking that shit? They're like, are you a nigga? No. I am a complication. Oh, it's complicated now, huh? Oh, he's a nigga now, for sure. They handed that motherfucker his nigga card. Accepted nowhere. And you know what white people really mad at? When they love Tiger, that nigga was at their house, at the mansions, and they thinking back, you know, the motherfucker be like, Tiger, stay here with my wife. I'm gonna go to the store and get us some more wine. That white man sitting there now, he probably fucked my wife. Cause Tiger was slanging dick. What I like about Tiger, he kept it golf. He had 18 holes. One for every hole of golf. $750 million he had to pay his ex-wife. Ladies, y'all need to chill the fuck out. Since when did pussy become higher case value than dick? It all begins with dick. Fucking don't begin till a dick get hard. When a dick goes off, fucking's over. Now, here's where Tiger messed up. Now, fellas, I want y'all to look at the woman sitting next to you that you brought here. Look at her right now. Look at her. Now, you see how fine she is? Don't ever fuck nothing uglier than her. You don't fuck down, you fuck up. You fuck a woman uglier than your woman, she gonna be mad than a motherfucker. Nigga, I know I look better than that bitch. Nigga, what's wrong with me? What's wrong with me? That's when they go crazy. What the fuck is wrong with me? I look better than that bitch. What's wrong with me? You fuck a bitch that's finer than your woman, she gonna act like she mad. But she can't get mad. She gonna look at him like, shit, I didn't know that nigga could catch that. I'ma have to step my game up. Rich black man and white woman don't go together. As OJ, Kobe, Tiger Woods, it ain't no good. Because white women will set your ass smooth the fuck up. Oh, nigga, they better learn their history. See, they say black women are the strongest women on earth in a way. But at least a sister gonna let you know up front. Nigga, I will fuck you up. You know what you're dealing with. White women, sneaky. Really? It's like that, Tom. Them bitches grab the phone. Hello? Officer? He raped me. White women play victim quick in a motherfucker. But that white man got a line for you white women. See, when that white man get mad, he get mad. You know, brothers, we get mad, we march. We shall overcome. You know, we get a good march in, misspell signs, we gone, you know. That white man get mad, nigga, he snap. You know, white women like, I'm taking the kids, I'm taking the house. We're gone, we're out of here, you asshole. That white man be like this. I came from a long line of Brookshires. You're not gonna take my seed from me, Guinevere. Now here's the one sentence that white man got for the ass. Over my dead body. And that motherfucker mean that shit. Over my dead body. I'll kill you, then I'll kill the kids, I'll burn the fucking house to the ground, then I'll do myself. Brother can't even try that shit. Sister be like, nigga, I'm leaving you. I'ma kill you. You killing who? Let the killing begin, motherfucker. Oh, nigga, let's get some killing going. Oh, nigga, what, motherfucker? What? Nigga be like, I'm just playing, girl. I'm just playing. You know I'm joking with you, girl. You know I'm joking with you. You know I'm joking with you. We don't even get to the part of burning the house down, the kids. They always try to make it like everybody's after the white woman. You look at the movies. King Kong after the bitch. Now, y'all know damn well this is a nigga story. You know, the big old gorilla. He had all them fine African sisters seen one white woman and lost his mind. That's why they call it jungle fever. That motherfucker Kong got that white bitch nigga he picked up just blowing on the hoe. I got him a white bitch. I got a white bitch. They took his white bitch. That motherfucker swam to New York. They took the bitch up on the building. Where's my white bitch? I need my white bitch. Dracula after the bitch. Where the white bitch? Where the white bitch? You ain't never seen Dracula bite a sister. Sister be like, you better put them motherfucking fangs up. Don't be coming around my neck with that bullshit. I ain't freaky like that. Now you can eat my pussy, nigga. I'm on my period. You want some blood? Dracula bite fresh bitches. Bitch, on a period, all the blood you want, motherfucker. You know what I mean? You can pull the tampon out, suck on it like a lollipop. Use the string like dinner plug. They got some new kind of white women now. You know, I'm in my 40s. You know, I remember when all white women had straight backs. You know what I mean? No ass, just a long back. You know, you can lay them down, get a good crease in your pants. You know. Ironing boards like a mother. Now they got some ass on them. I don't know what you white women are eating, but keep it up. They be walking down the street, gaga-on, gaga-on. You got competition, LaQuisha. Because, you know, every city I go to on tour, there's always the brother with the white woman. Now, brothers, let me ask y'all something, because I see a couple of y'all here with your white woman. Why, when y'all get a white woman, y'all get the ugliest white bitch in town? And be walking proud with them. Yeah, that's just mine. Holding hands and shit. You know what I mean? Brothers don't even hold hands with their own sister. You know what I mean? You watch a brother walking down the street, sister be behind him. Nigga, I'm with you. Come on, keep up. They get a white woman act like he hit the jackpot. Yes, I got her. But when you see a white man with a sister, oh, they get the baddest sister they got in town. Oh, white boys don't fuck around. When they get a sister, they get a sister. And they be walking, holding hands, goddamn right, I got her. I'm gonna teach her how to river dance. Nothing against you white people, y'all just different. You know how the motherfuckers say they don't like black people, right? And the ones that I'm talking about you. Not all white people, there's some cool motherfuckers. You're here. Obviously, motherfucker, you're here. But you know the ones I'm talking about, them motherfucking racist sons of bitches. You understand me? I don't like black people. Well, why you lay out in the sun and try to become black? You don't see black people laying out in the moonlight trying to lighten up. Like, brother, what you doing, nigga? I'm trying to get that Prince tone, nigga. Morris Day up in this bitch, nigga. Be happy to be white folks. Y'all ain't even white, really. Y'all colored. Y'all should all join the NAACP. Yeah, when these niggas gonna change the name of that organization? The National Association for the Advancement of Colored People. Now, fucker, we ain't been colored people since the 40s. I mean, we became Negroes, then we became niggas, and now we African Americans. Motherfucker, treat me like a hot dog and ketchup. And anybody should be saying they the NAACP is white folks. You understand me? Because y'all colored people. Only white people can turn red when they mad. Look at them. They blush. They're a little pink. When you hit them, they blue and purple. Y'all colored people like a motherfucker. Y'all the whole box of goddamn crayons. Shit, I might be blushing right now. You can't tell. Damn shit, Comedy Central done fucked up. They done fucked around and gave this nigga a special. You know, the rest of them like, I don't say the N-word no more, you know, I ain't. We done with that. I'm an African, I'm a nigga. Go life. Nigga. And I said nigga, white people. I didn't say nigger. Two different motherfucking words. That girl part will get you fucked up. Nigger, sound like you're growling at me. Feel a rope around my neck. And them motherfuckers got the audacity to get mad because they can't say it. What was that white bitch? Dr. Lord, that stank bitch. All on the news talking about nigger, 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 nigger. I said, where's a nigga to smack this bitch? Well, why can't I say it? Bitch, did your people ever get put into slavery? Did a motherfucker oppress you for 450 years and counting, motherfucker? Well, you ain't earned the right to say that word. You understand me? We all got words we can't say. They act like it's only us. You understand me? Every culture's got their word. Mexicans can call each other beaners. You go over there and say that shit and not get your ass cut. Italians call each other guinea wops. So I'm saying, everybody got their shit. Y'all was concerned with what a nigga saying. I can't say nigger. You sure can't, motherfucker. You know what I mean? That's like me going to a Klan rally. How you crackers doing? And expect not to get hung the fuck up. We killing so much of each other, we done put the Klan out of business. That's why you don't see the Klan no more. They like, well, damn it, we used to hang one darky a week. They're doing 15 every 15 minutes. Take your sheets off, it's all over. We're gonna have to call ourselves the Tea Party. Cause you know the Tea Party ain't nothing but the Klan and street clothes. And I always had that one brother at their rally they put on the news. And I know y'all be saying the same shit. You sit at home like, where did they find this motherfucker? He always got scars on his head and shit. This is a good rally. They're doing good things. And they, I said, where they find this homeless ass nigga today? They done bought this nigga a bucket of Kentucky Fried Chicken. And then good rally. The Mexicans and Chinese are out fucking us. You ain't gonna outfuck them Chinese. It's 1.6 billion of them motherfuckers. And they women always act like they don't fuck. Oh no, yeah, I just meet. How the fuck is it 1.6 billion of y'all if y'all ain't fucking? That's because they fuck quick. They just like, take out. You know what I mean? They don't even get into it. They got... Now we go back in the workout. They trying to tell our Mexican brothers and sisters that they need to stay away from the border. I don't understand that when California is Mexico. Listen to the name of it, California. San Diego, San Francisco, San Jose. If it start with San, it's Mexican. Ain't no cities called William Brookshire. You know what I mean? Had audacity to call a Mexican a wetback. They crossed a river. White people, y'all came on a boat. Crossed an ocean. So if they back is motherfucking wet, you dipped. I always talking about my country. White people, this ain't y'all country. Y'all annexed it. You stole it from the Indians. I know you said you discovered it. You know how to use them slick-ass words. We discovered it. How you discover some shit a motherfucker already live in? Using that analogy, when I get off stage, I'm gonna discover somebody's car. Police like, did you steal it? No, I discovered it. I gave the indigenous driver a reservation in the trunk. Nigga, look. My man, LeBron James, you know, the brother went to Miami, you know, which he has all right to do. You know, it's called free agency. The first word is free. That nigga's free. Them white people in Cleveland got all mad, burning the nigga jersey, doing little statues of him, setting on fire. Like, he play basketball. This ain't a politician that could change your life. He dribble. He dunk. Yay. You know what I mean? I just want an hour of my life back. It shouldn't have took him an hour. You know, he just sat there. I'm going to South Beach. Nigga! You big motherfucking... If I wasn't a Christian... And you can tell them I said it, shit. You know what I mean? The reason I heard that he left is because one of the dudes on the team was sleeping with his mama. Y'all heard that shit too? I found out when I did the show in Cleveland, the audience told me. I said, is it true? They like, yeah, yeah, we all knew, we all knew. I'm like, are y'all wondering why he gave y'all the finger and left? He from y'all his hometown. Y'all love a nigga. Somebody should have came up to the brother. Hey, you know when you delivering that bad, bad news, you gotta. Hey, you know my man and your mama. I just thought I'd let you know, nigga. I just thought I'd let you know. And what's the nigga name that did it? Dante West, that's some fucked up shit. Cause that nigga, when he play against LeBron, he can get in that nigga's head. He D'ing that nigga, hey LeBron. You know me and your moms. You know what I mean? That's like me and Chris Rock doing a movie together and he's sleeping with my mama. I'ma have to rock Chris Rock. You don't fuck moms. Moms off limit. You can fuck my sister. You know what I mean? She grown. She want to give you some pussy. Hey. But you don't put your dick in where I came out. Michael Vick doing his thing, ain't he? You understand me? You can't keep a brother down. They put that boy in the game, the rest is history. You understand me? And I don't know why they did that brother the way they did him about some damn dogs. He had some pet bulls. Now here's the shit that fucked with me. There's a dog fight going on. He 3 states away. He ain't even at the house and they lock him up. And his cousins ain't shit. You staying at his house for free. You there when the dog fight go down, the bus come. One of them supposed to take the rap. Is this Michael Vick? No, this me. They just slapped him on the wrist, $150,000 fine, nigga, nothing. They want to make an example out of motherfucking Vick. They want every black man to have an actress. Kobe Bryant, rape white bitch. Michael Jordan, gambled. Michael Vick, dog fight. Eddie Griffin, said nigga. Tricky white people. Y'all love dogs more than y'all love human beings. I watch y'all. You see white people, they see a stray dog. You see them, they be like, where's your home? What's your name? Let me read your tag. You have a number. We're gonna call your master. We're gonna find your home. A homeless dude walk up. Can I get some change? Get away from me, you bum. Don't lock this brother up about a dog. It's called a pet bull. They bred to fight. The dog wants to fight. The dog sitting in the backyard. I wanna fuck something up. You know what I'm saying? I ain't no poodle. What the fuck you got me back here for? Man, we'll bring that bitch on. I'll fuck that motherfucker up. You understand me? They ain't trying to stop a rodeo. White people go to rodeo, you got motherfucking shocks on the goddamn bull's nuts to make it hop around. Oh, that's humane. Shut them rodeos down. I'll stop fighting my motherfucking dogs. I'm from the Midwest. We fight dogs. Still having cockfights, ain't you? You motherfuckers. If I wasn't a Christian. Yeah. Drink up, y'all. It's Saturday. Spoken like a true alcoholic. You know, alcoholic come up with any reason to drink. Why you drinking? It's Saturday. Why you drinking? It's Sunday. Jesus had wine at the Last Supper. It's Monday, first day back at the job. It's Tuesday, kids getting on my goddamn nerve. It's Wednesday, hump day. It's Thursday, almost Friday. It's Friday, thank God. It's Saturday, that's what I'm saying. Hey, get fucked up, be somebody else. You know what I mean? You got a slave for another motherfucker on the job all week long. Saturday, get here, man, get faded and be somebody else. They be like, who are you? I'm Michael Jackson. Till Sunday. And in case you were wondering, hey, what you drinking, eh? It's called the liquid blunt. You know what I'm saying? It's Vu-Clicquot champagne. Give you the same high as a blunt. You don't go up, you don't go down, you maintain. You understand me? And police pull me over, they can't say, you have some weed on you? I don't. And it's called Vu-Clicquot. It's actually the first champagne ever created. Because I research anything I put in my temple. All right? And it's some French shit.
So for those of you who are talking that shit, I hate the French. Fuck you. I like the French. If you hate the French, dig up the Statue of Liberty and send that bitch back. They made her. If you hate the French, keep your tongue in your mouth when you kiss, because it's called a French kiss. It ain't called a redneck kiss. And put the croissant down, nigga, because that's French too. I like the French. Oui, oui, très bon. Je m'appelle Edouard. You never know what a nigga know. And if you're Japanese, genga daska domi aragato. Moshi moshi. And if you're Chinese, ni hao ma. She she ni. Wa ani. But this is the liquid blunt. Now, he named it after his wife. Now, if you buy a bottle of the shit, it costs $45 at Costco. I don't get it twisted. I don't give a fuck how much money I got. I'm frugal in a motherfucker. Shit, you don't stay rich by spending the shit, nigga. $45. You see them fools in them damn videos, nigga, $500 for a bottle of Cristal at a strip club. Nigga, I ain't paying $500 for nothing. Suck my dick. $45. And the shit is good. But he named it after his wife. You buy a bottle, there's a picture of her on the cap. Now, when you look at the picture of this fat, ugly bitch, you will figure out why he created a drink. He like, I need a drink before I fuck your fat, ragged ass. I need some bubbles for my troubles. I just finished my second DUI. I ain't trying to get a third, because you know California law, you get that third one, it's an automatic year in the penitentiary area. I ain't trying to go to jail by no drinking, because you get to jail, ain't no drinking. I remember I was rolling out, man, I'm coming down Sunset in L.A. one night, and I was high in the motherfucker. Now I had a couple of this, you know, I'm doing me, you know, and I think I'm doing good. You know, I'm whipping it. And you know, brothers, we drive with one eye in the rearview mirror and the other one on the road to make sure Popo ain't behind. So I'm doing my shit, and I seen the lights. I didn't know I was in the car chase for about 5 minutes. I'm that high, I seen the lights, and in my head, I'm like, it's Christmas already? They got all these lights and shit. I didn't know till a cop car pulled in front of me and cut me the fuck off and pulled me over. And that's when you try to get sober quick. You're like, you know how you do. Shit, I got this. All right, let me get this shit off of me, nigga. That over there, stash pocket, boom, clap. And you got to pull the wallet out if you a black man. You don't want to get caught reaching. They shoot us. He was reaching for something. Nigga, I be having my wallet out, ID showing, clap, clap. Window already down. I'm ready for you. Come on, come on. And the motherfucker asked me some stupid shit. He said, would you like to step out of the car? I said, well, since it's a yes or no answer, no, I would not like to step out of the car. That's when they snatched little motherfucker out. Then they try to make you do the gymnastic competition. You know, touch your nose, spin around, do a straight line. I said, hold on, man. Didn't you just pull me over for a reason? Now, why the hell you want a nigga moonwalking and shit? He's like, Eddie, so you're saying you're drunk? I said, no, Your Honor. I mean, officer. I ain't drunk. I'm fucked up. There is a difference. I can drive drunk. I'm fucked up. That's why I thought I was going straight. That motherfucker said, so you're that comedian. I said, yep, that's why I'm funny. What the fuck you doing in that monkey suit? He's like, he's funny in real life. I said, look, man. He's like, Eddie, I'm gonna do you a favor. You gonna let a brother go? Nope, not gonna do that. I
said, well, what the fuck is it then?
He said, I was wondering if I could take a picture with you for my son and the kids.
I said, motherfucker, you let a nigga go, we can take pictures all night. That's when they said, click, click. Now, they sat my black ass on the curb. Sunset Boulevard, nigga. Fans driving by, and you know how motherfuckers are, nigga. They don't know, you know what I mean? Nigga, I entertain, but I'm a real motherfucker. I'm on the corner, click, click, and niggas riding by. Hey, what up? I'm like, nigga, I can't wave back. Nigga, you love a nigga that much, pull over, help me. Nigga, I'm fucked up, I can't talk for myself. Explain to this motherfucker. See, nigga, this motherfucker put me in the car. I'm in the back, it's an uncomfortable ride, you know, and they got the shit on tight, nigga, he back there, look at this motherfucker, and you can't get comfortable, shit. And I'm sitting in the back, I'm so fucked up, I'm still clowning. It was a white dude and a fat female white cop. And I'm sitting in the back, I looked at her fat, funky ass. Y'all know my mouth, nigga. Some people can edit, it just fly out. That's what my mama said. You know Eddie telling the truth. That nigga thinking it fly out his motherfucking mouth. I looked at her ass, nigga. I said, shit, I ain't never seen a police uniform with stretch marks on it. Her partner is sitting behind her. He's like, this motherfucker is crazy for real. They got me down to the station, that's when they handcuff you to that little bench. So I'm on that wooden bench, nigga, and I'm clowning this fat bitch. The night watchman jumped off the desk and said, put that ignorant motherfucker in the cage. They locked me up in that motherfucker. It's a Friday night. Brothers, y'all know what I'm talking about. You there for the weekend. I don't know if you've been to jail recently. They done took out all the TVs. They done took the weights out. They literally in there curling little niggas. Nigga, they make you put your legs together tight and they curl these little motherfuckers. Nigga, I was so tired of getting curled, nigga. Nigga, I got in that motherfucker. They stuck me in the cell with the Crip of the Century. I got in there, that motherfucker was dipped blue doo-doo-doo-doo. I said, they put me in with the Smurf. Every other word is like, what up, cub? What's going on, cub? What you seen that, cub? Now, y'all know I'm from Kansas City, Missouri, right? This is when I'm first getting to L.A. Nigga, I'm like, Bloods in the Hood and all that shit wasn't on TV yet. I'm sitting there, cub. I'm like, we related? Cub. Nigga, you like, no, cub. You know what I'm saying, cub? And the nigga kept doing this kind of shit. I'm like, these niggas in L.A. is a bunch of deaf mutes out here. Yeah, you know. Nigga, and I'm like, I don't speak that yet. All I know is this and that. He like, nigga, ain't you Eddie Griffin, cuz? Ain't you Eddie Griffin, cuz? I'm like, yeah, motherfucker, you fucking my high up. Nigga, and then a nigga start dancing on me, nigga. I looked at that nigga, I said, nigga, teach me that. Like, nigga, let me see that shit. So I got to hollering at the little nigga as the nigga high start coming down. I said, nigga, why y'all do that shit? He like, you know, cuz. I'm like, nigga, I'm from Kansas City, Missouri, nigga. When I grew up, we didn't have no gangs. Nigga be like, nigga, what's your gang? Self. The older brothers in here know what I'm talking about. Back in the day, you had yourself. You got a gang, nigga, me, myself, and I. Your partner showed up to make sure his partners didn't jump in. Whoever you got beef with, nigga, mano a mano, head up, nigga, what up, nigga? If you get your ass whooped, go to the gym and practice. That nigga had that left hook. Got to keep that right up. Keep that right up.
Come with it, nigga.
Because we being so soft with our kids nowadays, man, this shit get on my nerves. They locking parents up because the kid had a fight at school. Yeah, I mean, what kind of, you know, we raising little bitch-ass motherfuckers? Nigga, a fight is in God's plan. You supposed to fight as a kid. That lets you know where you fit in on the food chain. You thought you was Billy Badass. Then you ran into Billy Badass. Billy Badass whooped that ass, you figure out. I'm good at math. These little motherfuckers nowadays, man, they get it 12 on one. And nigga be bragging, nigga, we whooped his ass, nigga. We whooped his ass. You better had 12 on one, you bitch-made motherfucker. You don't get no stripes for that, nigga. Motherfuckers done gone berserk. You know what I mean? They don't even know Bloods and Crips started right here in Oakland. It's an offshoot of the Black Panthers. I'm gonna teach y'all something tonight. When the feds came to break up the Black Panthers, you know, they shooting UEP and everybody up, you know, getting these niggas all doped up and shit, because the movement was too strong. Two of the brothers went down to LA. One went to Inglewood and started the Bloods. Which meant, if the police fuck with anybody on this block, we all blood, we all family, we stand together. All right? Another one went down to Compton, started the Crips. Crips stand for Community Resistance in Progress. If you fuck with anybody in this community, the community has got a resistance in progress, officer. You ask these little youngsters now, hey, what Crip mean? It mean Crip Cup. It mean Crip Cup. It mean Crip Cup. And what is this retarded walk, nigga? The fuck is wrong with you, nigga? You just got out the zoo? Nigga, walk like a motherfucking man. Fuck wrong with you? Some motherfucking animal, nigga. You playing white into the white man stereotype of us. You know what I mean? Chill the fuck out on that red and blue, nigga. You understand me? Nigga. I don't even understand, nigga. We both broke. You a blood, I'm a crip, we broke. Come together like butt cheeks and be the shit. So I'm sitting in this cage, you know, I'm educating the little brother, right? And the brother was sagging. And I said, hey, brother, let me explain something to you. You know, my hide done came off. And y'all know I get real cerebral when a nigga sober. I'm like, look, bro, I want to let you know where that sagging shit started. It started in the penitentiary area. Them fags in there would sag to advertise their ass. They get out of jail, nigga, and they put the drawers on still sagging, but try to play like they men. The kids thought the shit was slick and the kids start sagging. Right. My son did that shit at age 16 years old. He's 25 now, Eddie Jr. I'm in the house, nigga. I'm a single father. I'm cooking Eddie spaghetti. Because that's all the fuck I know how to cook other than a hot dog. But I can fuck some spaghetti up, nigga. I'll make an Italian move out of Italy up in this motherfucker. So, you know, I'm making my spaghetti. Junior walk in the door and he's sagging. Nigga, I put the shit on simmer. I said, Junior, grab a little seat right there on that bar stool. Like, well, what up, Pop? Oh, it's a lot up, nigga. And it's a lot down. I said, nigga, grab yourself a beer. I can drink. Today you can. That nigga sat down. I explained the story to him. I said, nigga, sagging started in the penitentiary area. Fags was advertising the crack of their ass. You sagging? Sagging is fagging. That nigga had on two belts. He was flooding like a motherfucker. That nigga walking through the house, I ain't no bitch.
I tell you, that's my little nigga. Let's put this flame back on.
Spaghetti be ready in a minute.
Explain that to my little crip partner. I think he all right. And I'm saying the little nigga, the little homie walked up to me, he's like, cuz, that was proper, cuz. You know, he still had a little bit of the walk, but he straightened it up a lot. You know, I'm a getting that. We black men, we always got some flavor on our stroll, you know. You know, you see a brother walk, you can damn near hear music. Because we walking in rhythm, moving in stride, nigga, you be hearing, boom, chicka, 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 boom, chicka, chicka. Every nigga got a soundtrack, nigga. Boom, chicka, 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 boom, chicka, chicka, chicka. You got some niggas like, doom, 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 doom. You got some niggas like, doom, doom, chaco, doom, doom, chaco. You know them head swinging niggas, they be walking, nigga, the head is. Remember Michael Jordan, that nigga going down the court, nigga, that head just above. White guys ain't got no rhythm. 3, 4, 5. Hell yeah. Yeah, baby. Hell yeah, if you a little motherfucker my size, shut the fuck up. It's always them little barking motherfuckers, you know.
Then nigga, I'll fuck this whole place up. Nigga don't know me, nigga. Nigga don't know me, nigga.
Boy.
Shut your little ass up, man. You know what I mean? Because them ain't the scary ones. The quiet motherfuckers. That's who you watch. Them the killers. You know, the loudest motherfucker in the club is a bitch. That nigga loud because he's scared and he hope it's scaring you. Nigga, you know what I'm saying? I'm fucking up. Is this scaring y'all? Because I'm scaring the motherfucker. Real killers are quiet in the mother. They don't dance. They sit in the club and hold the wall up and just be looking. And you know, they constantly got a grit on their face. You know? Niggas do a slow stroll through the club and they praying the whole time. God, don't let me kill nobody else today. And then somebody step on his shoe, he be like. They try to let it slide, but niggas like that can't. You on the dance floor and he'll walk up to you. Excuse me, bro. You know, you stepped on my shoes, you know. I was wondering if you apologize, you know. So I paid for mine just like you paid for yours, you know. So, you know, if you give a brother apology, you know, we can go on and clean this on up, you know what I'm saying? That nigga be like, nigga, fuck you and your shoes, old bitch ass niggas. Why he tell this motherfucker that? That's when they get that walk, nigga. Bloop, 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 bloop. Club clearing out like roaches when the light come on. That motherfucker walk out, don't nobody know what happened. He's still praying. God, I told you. You know how I am. You go on and sort him out because he wasn't cool down here. As my grandfather said, there's certain people that deserve a whole lot of leave alone. Who? Hey, my dear, happy birthday, baby.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
To you.
Oh,
Happy birthday, dear mama. We appreciate you, baby. Yes, indeed. That's everybody, mama. Shit. You know what I mean? That's how that shit's supposed to go, man. I be seeing some of these little young motherfuckers, and they see one of their elders going across the street. Man, get your old ass out the way. Y'all see that shit? Beat the dog shit out that motherfucker. You got the right to rap, run around, and do all your dumb shit, because sisters like her and brothers her age, they put it down. You see your eldest nigga, help her across the street. Help his ass across the street. I don't make you no damn man, you little buck-ass motherfucker. Some of these little retarded motherfuckers get on my goddamn nerve. Kids and don't none of them want for shit. You know, I hear motherfuckers talking about child support on one kid, I just laugh. I'm like, that's it? Shit, nigga. Come to my world. Shit, 2 ex-wives, 4, 5 baby mamas. My first of the month calls is a motherfucker. Hey, nigga, you got no money? 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 Shit, I thought I was pimping. I'm doing shows for them. They pimping the shit out my black ass. Nigga, go do some shows. I bet you they get together and huddle, nigga. I get a movie, they be like, come on, girl. We got a movie. But I wouldn't trade one of my babies in to save my motherfucking life. Because really, at the end of life, that's all you motherfucking leave. You don't take no money with you. You understand me? I ain't never seen a Brinks truck pull up to a funeral. The Egyptians tried to take the money with them. Ain't they digging them motherfuckers up? Now King Tut on tour. This dead motherfucker still on tour. They work a nigga after death. And if they could legally get away with digging Michael up, that nigga be on tour too. Where's Michael? He's on tour. That nigga in the casket in the music play. That's why I smoke and I drink. Because when I'm dead, I don't want nobody walking by my casket talking about, damn, Ed look good. If I look good, I should still be motherfucking alive. I want a motherfucker walking by my casket and say, God damn, I see why that nigga dead. Nigga, fuck that shit. It ain't the quality of life. Or the quantity, it's the quality. You understand me? Would you really want to live to be 199 years old? Shitting on yourself. You come in the world in diapers. If you gotta leave in depends, nigga, you stayed too long. If it looked like I'm about to shit on myself, unplug me, nigga. Cause life is for the living. And motherfuckers that are alive and love you don't want to unplug you because they love you. Motherfucker, let me go. I said I'm tired. Now unplug this shit, nigga. I want to see what the next part look like. Because I know this ain't the end. Energy ain't dissipated, it's transferred. The spirit animates this clay we motherfucking trapped in. You understand me? Clay dropped the fuck down. My spirit going on to the next phase, nigga. Now leave me fuck alone. You understand me? I had my fun. And some of you old motherfuckers ain't playing fair. You know, they got this new shit, Viagra.
Cialis. I think God put a ticking clock on the dick. Your dick supposed to be done right around the speed limit. Ain't no need in you having no kids after 55. Your ass ain't gonna be here when they get out of school. Now play fair, put the pill down, shut your dick up. Cause a young motherfucker's supposed to be our turn to get some damn pussy, motherfucker. Old nigga already established, he got a business, he got a motherfucking Rolls Royce. He getting all the young pussy and the young nigga like this. But baby, what, you know. She like, you ain't got no car, I'm going with sugar daddy. You old niggas, put your old wrinkled up monster up. And you know them old niggas be cheating, nigga. Right now, they popping their pill because they know the show almost over. Because they know it take an hour for it to kick in. I'm going to be ready for you after this show, y'all. I'm going to be ready for you. Hey, I drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Nigga, if y'all think I'm funny, my grandfather is the funniest motherfucker outside of Richard Pryor I ever met. My granddaddy would sit on the front porch, he'd be like, look at here. I like young hoes. I said, young hoes? He's like, yeah, nigga, if you catch me with something over 27, I'm holding it for the police. All I can show a 30-year-old bitch is where the old folks' home is. You know how many dicks she done seen in 30 years at it? I like young hell. He said, Eddie, I had one so young last night when I got done, I had the Berber. I couldn't even call him a dirty old man. I was like, huh? Because the nigga explained to me, he said, there's one thing an old motherfucker don't want, and that's an old bitch. Two old motherfuckers don't go together. Dust flying everywhere.
Don't go? Hey, baby, I had to come to the yay area.
Because I know up here, y'all motherfuckers is sharp. You know what I mean? And you still street at the same time, so you... You know what I mean? You actually see niggas with books up here. You know what I mean? If you want to stop motherfuckers from dealing dope on your block on the corner, walk up and hand them niggas a book. Watch them run. Hey, nigga, what's wrong with that nigga trying to get me to read? All these words and stuff. Yeah, they say white people are scared of a nigga with a gun. No, they ain't. When they see your ass with a gun, here's what they do. Gotcha. He'll be in jail soon. They see your ass with a book. Try this shit, because I do it all the time. Go to Starbucks or one of them little, you know, coffee shop shits. Sit down with a book. White person sitting over there, they can't resist it, nigga. They just be like. They have to get up, nigga.
Hello. What are you reading?
And I fuck with them. How to kill white people. Get a book, man. Reading is fun to mental. Fun to mental.
It ain't illegal yet, but they working on it.
I want the young motherfuckers in here tonight, no matter what your nationality is, turn the motherfucking TV off for 1 week and see if you can survive. Motherfuckers are going to a television junkie motherfucking mode. Nigga, ain't no TV. I need my remote, nigga. I'm jonesing. Nigga, it's called television programming. They telling you visually to program. You being programmed, nigga. You watch it on the news. It was on CNN, it's true. I seen it on Fox. It's real. It's bullshit. You know Obama ain't running shit. Puppet on the string. That nigga ran for office and said, I'ma stop both wars. Didn't he just send 60,000 more troops to Afghanistan? He took them out of Iraq. Them niggas thought they was going home. Shit, nigga, the war over. We going home. He like, nope, over there. That's some fucked up shit. They wise and shit, family thinking these motherfuckers coming home, nigga, they get shipped to a new war. And you know these wars is about what? Money, 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 money. Now, Iraq, we annexed that country. You know, took the oil, nigga. Now, if one thing you know about American motherfucking history, wherever we land, we don't leave. We already got 3 bases, permanent bases, in Iraq. We still in Vietnam, still in motherfucking Korea, still got a base in Japan. Everywhere we land, we don't leave. You know what I mean? I thought it was called the United States of America, not the United Empire of Earth. You will do as I say. How the fuck we gonna go over to Iraq and tell them we giving these people freedom? They didn't ask for it. Wasn't no Iraqis over there. Come on over here, we wanna vote. Them motherfuckers was chilling. Now we over in Afghanistan. You know what we there for? Opium. The 90% of the world's opium comes from holla at your boy. Now, in the Buddhist religion, they smoke opium. There's 1.6 billion Chinese. In order to control China, you must control opium. China owns 90% of our debt. Welcome to China. Learn the language, ni hao ma. Xie xie ni. The Chinese ain't to be fucked with. One Bruce Lee would fuck up this whole room. 1.6 billion Bruce Lees, nigga, leave him alone. Oh, America know who to attack. You ain't never seen them go fuck with China. Remember, China had one of our motherfuckers as students in Tiananmen Square beating the shit out of him on national television with a bamboo motherfucking stick. Did America go and attack? Nope. You know what they said? What is he doing over there? Somebody get his parents on the phone. That Bruce Lee was a bad motherfucker. 5'7", 140 pounds. Dynamite. You understand me? That motherfucker in the movie, you seen that motherfucker, he walk in the dojo. 300 motherfuckers. Bruce walk in, nigga. And you know, I love that nigga walk, nigga. He had a little walk. Oh, he was a chigga. A chigga, a Chinese nigga. That little motherfucker had some nigga in him, nigga. We can fight one at a time. All together. If you sitting in that dojo, you gotta ask yourself 2 questions. Either he got a bomb on his ass, or he's really a bad motherfucker. Neither one of them are good. And remember the motherfucking teachers always like, Wang, Chang, Ling Lang Wang, Wang. They run out there and get killed, nigga. Then he go with the second set. Wang, Ching, Ching Chong, Bang, Wong Long. Nigga, if I'm in that second set, I'd have been like, hey, hey, hold the fuck up. Then was your black belts. My shit is orange. You the teacher, teach. Now, if you whoop his ass, I'll keep taking your class. If not, I'm about to study with that motherfucker. I'm Eddie Griffin. Y'all be wonderful. Good night, old man.